So now we'll discuss about alkyl aryl halides, which are halogen derivatives. So as we are aware, if you take hydrocarbons, we are having only the carbon and hydrogen, and in the hydrocarbons, if you replace any hetero atom like halogens, oxygens, etc., we'll get the different compounds. Today we'll discuss about the halogen derivatives, which are called as alkyl aryl halides. For example, if you take methane, which is CH4, which is hydrocarbon, in this hydrocarbon let us replace one hydrogen with one halogen atom, so we'll get the compound. For example, I'm taking Cl, chlorine, this is methyl chloride or chloromethane, so which is the halogen derivative of the corresponding CH4. So if we take, for example, C2H6, which is ethane, in this replace one hydrogen with some halogen, so we can write as C2H5X, where X is the halogen. The X can be fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine. So that's why the compound which are formed by replacing hydrogens of the hydrocarbon are generally called as halogen compounds or halogen derivatives. Halogen derivatives. So let us see the various alkyl halides now. Here we have different kinds of the alkyl halides. Like, let us see the classification. Here the classification we come across, here especially we come across about the simple alkyl halides. In the alkyl halides, we have the carbon which is sp3 hybridized. This carbon is sp3 hybridized. Now assume we have one halogen atom here. So these are a kind of alkyl halides where the halogen is attached to sp3 carbon. Like I have seen CH3Cl, CH3Br or C2H5Cl, C2H5Br. If all these come across, all these the categories where the halogen atom is attached to the sp3 carbon atom. sp3 carbon atom. And apart from this, if we take, for example, the compounds where this is a benzene ring, we have CH2X. These are benzylic halides. So in this case, here we can see this carbon also sp3 carbon. So both the case we can see here the halogen atom is present on the sp3 carbon atom. So let us see various examples here. Both the case, if you see here, they're all mono halogen compounds, because here we have only one halogen atom attached to the corresponding carbon atom. Both the cases the carbon is sp3 carbon atom. That means we can say here mono halogen derivatives So it takes simple general alkanes formula as CnH2n+2. This is alkanes general formula. Now in this, replace one hydrogen with halogen, we can write the general formula as CnH2n+1X. So which can be also written as RX, which are alkyl halides. As I already told you, it can be fluorine, chlorine, bromine or iodine. So if you take F here, alkyl fluoride, see here alkyl chloride, alkyl bromide, alkyl iodide. In the respective cases, the halogen where to which carbon it is attached, the carbon is generally sp3 hybridized carbon. Apart from this, if you take, for example, you take propane. This is the propane. So in this propane, replace any one of the hydrogen with the corresponding halogen. If you take, for example, this is the first carbon atom, this is the second carbon atom, this is the third carbon atom. Now I am replacing the hydrogen of the first carbon with halogen. So we can write it as CH3, CH2, CH2. For example, take the halogen as Cl. Or I am replacing hydrogen of the second carbon atom. That is, we'll get as CH3, CH, Cl, CH3. But here, if you come across, this is present on the second carbon atom of the propane. This is present on the first carbon atom of the corresponding propane. Anyway, these two are derivatives of the propane. And here, in 11th standard, you might have heard about the primary carbon, secondary carbons, and tertiary carbons. If you take this particular carbon atom, here this carbon attached to only one other carbon atom. So this carbon is 1 degree or primary carbon. If you take this carbon atom, the middle one, which attached to two other carbons, this is generally called as the secondary carbon, 2 degree carbon. That's why the first case, we can say this is primary alkyl halide. This is secondary or 2 degree alkyl halides. So because in the first case, halogen is present on the primary carbon atom. In this case, the halogen is present on the secondary carbon atom, but both comes under the monohalogen derivatives. Monohalogen derivatives, but we can say these two are actually isomers, because if you come across this, we can call this as N-propyl chloride. This is isopropyl chloride, or this is primary alkyl halide, this is secondary alkyl halide. These two are actually isomers because these two have same general formulae. Number of carbons are same in both the case. Number of hydrogens are same in the both the case. And the halogen is chlorine here, here also chlorine only. So both have same molecular formulae, but there are difference in the arrangement of the halogen, nothing but chlorine atom. Thus these are actually called as the isomers. Isomers, especially the positional isomers, because on the first carbon we have chlorine here, on second carbon we have chlorine here. So that's why it is 1-chloro compound, this is 2-chloro compound. Otherwise it is 1-chloropropane, this is 2-chloropropane. Both are monohalogen derivatives, monohalogen derivatives. And apart from that, if we take the aromatic compounds, aromatic compound where this is the benzene ring, benzyl chloride, where here the chlorine present on again the carbon which is next to benzene ring. So this carbon is also, if you come across, this is sp3 carbon. Anyway, to this, if you observe this carbon, this is attached to only one carbon atom. So again, this is also a primary carbon atom or 1 degree carbon, or else you take 2 degree. You take another alkyl group here. So we can see here, if you take this carbon atom, it is attached to one carbon and other carbon atom here of the benzene ring. So it again comes under the 2 degree secondary. So come to the third case where all these comes under benzylic compounds. Halogen, two other alkyl groups. This particular carbon comes under 3 degree. Tertiary. In every case, if you take the carbon which is starred, this is sp3 carbon. So around sp3 carbon, generally the geometry will be tetrahedral. So all these comes under the monohalogen derivatives. And let us take the dihalogen derivatives. Dihalogen derivatives. So take for example CH2Cl2, or simply we can make it as CH2X2. X can be any halogen. Or else take the derivative of C2H6, can make it as CHCl2, otherwise CH2Cl, CH2Cl. So these are actually the dichloro compounds. Both are derivatives of the ethane, C2H6. But the difference between these two compounds we come across is, here both the halogens are present on the same carbon atom. But here, if you see, the halogens are present at the adjacent carbon atoms. This also we can say the isomers. Isomers, both the compounds, because both have the same molecular formulae, but the arrangement of the halogen atoms are different. Here both are present on the same carbon atom, but here both are present at the adjacent carbon atoms. Okay, and whenever the both the halogens are present on the same carbon atom, in such a case generally they generally called as gem dihalides or geminal dihalides. And if both the halogens are present at the adjacent carbon, they are generally called as vic or vicinal dihalides. So whenever you come across about dihalogen derivatives, especially in the case of derivatives of the corresponding alkanes, both the halogens are present on the same carbon atom, they are called as geminal dihalides. And if the halogens are present at the adjacent carbons, then they are called as vicinal dihalides. And if it is geminal dihalides, we can also call them as alkylidene halides. If they are present adjacent carbons, they are called as alkylene halides. Alkylene halides. So these represent exactly where the corresponding halogen atoms are present in the given compound. And if there are more than two halogens, we can also call them as polyhalogen compound. Thus we can say how we can have different kinds of the alkyl halides. And apart from that, the halogen atom can be present on the corresponding carbons. Here the carbon halogen bond, if you come across, the carbon can be sp3 carbon, or the carbon can be sp2 carbon. Suppose if it is sp3, I have already told you here, the carbon is sp3, it should have the tetrahedral geometry. Both the case, the derivatives of the corresponding alkanes as well as benzylic compounds. And if it is, the carbon is sp2 carbon, we can come across the allylic halides. The allylic halides are those in which, if you come across, for example, CH2 double bond CH2X. Actually, this is the sp3 carbon, but this is sp2 carbon. So allylic carbon is the one which is directly attached to the sp2 carbon. So this is allylic halide. So what is allylic compound mean? Generally, the carbon which is sp3, which is next to sp2 carbon, is generally called as allylic carbon. And on the allylic carbon, if halogen is present, we can call this compound as the allylic compound, allylic halide or allylic compound. Here also the carbon is sp3 carbon, sp3 carbon. And apart from that, if you take, for example, in this case the halogen is present or attached directly to the sp2 carbon. So this type of compound generally called as vinylic compounds, vinylic compounds. Or you take, for example, apart from this, I have a cyclic structure. So adjacent to this we have the halogen. Here this particular carbon is also sp2 carbon, sp2 carbon. Or if you take the aryl halides, this is the benzene ring. So where we have halogen atom attached to the benzene ring or the carbon of the benzene ring, where this particular carbon atom is sp2 carbon atom, sp2 carbon atom. So in every case, if you take this case, or if you take this case, or this third case, every case we can observe the halogen is attached or present on the carbon which is sp2 hybridized carbon. So based on the presence of the corresponding halogen on the corresponding carbon atom, we can also classify the compounds like this also. Now let us see the nature of CX bond. Here in the alkyl aryl halides, we have discussed that there is a bond between the halogen atom and carbon atom. Here in general, the halogens are more electronegative than that of the carbon atom. That's why if you take this particular electron pair or bond pair, this bond pair will move towards the more electronegative atom. Because of this reason, the halogen will have the partial negative charge. Carbon will have the partial positive charge. That's why this bond is a polar bond. That means in the alkyl halides, one can observe bond polarity. This leads to give the dipole moment. And because of this reason, there are many chemical properties which will vary. So this is about bond polarity or polar bond which is present between carbon atom and the halogen atom. And in general, we know that if you come across about the electronegativity, the order of electronegativity will be fluorine greater than, chlorine greater than, bromine greater than, iodine. At the same time, if you come across about the size of the halogens, we move from top to bottom in a particular group, the size gradually increases for the corresponding members. That's why if I come across about the size order, here it will be fluorine less than, chlorine less than, bromine less than, iodine. That's why if I come across about the carbon halogen bond distance, it gradually increases from carbon fluorine to carbon iodine. This is a bond length. The bond length gradually will be in the order of carbon fluorine less than, carbon chlorine less than, carbon bromine less than, carbon iodine. And because of this reason, generally what one can observe is that there is a, if you come across our bond cleavage, breaking of the carbon halogen single bond, it will be very, very easy when move from top to bottom. Because if you come across the bond between the carbon and fluorine atom, it is stronger bond. But between carbon and iodine, it will be weak bond. That's why the bond energy gradually decreases from carbon fluorine bond to the carbon iodine bond. That's why the bond energy values gradually decreases from top to bottom when we move among the carbon halogen bonds. And bond polarity gradually decreases from fluorine to iodine, because fluorine is the high electronegative atom and iodine is the least electronegative atom. That's why the carbon halogen bond polarity gradually decreases from top to bottom. This is the nature of the CX bond in the corresponding alkyl halides or the aryl halides. Now let us discuss about the naming of the corresponding alkyl halides. You call it as nomenclature. So generally we can use the common names or the name introduced by the IUPAC system. If it is common name, generally we can call them as alkyl halides. Alkyl halides. If it is IUPAC name, halogen is generally used as a substituent, which we call it as haloalkanes. Haloalkanes. For example, take a simple compound which is CH3Br. If it is common name, we can call it as methyl bromide. It is a common name. If it is IUPAC name, this is bromomethane. The first one is the common name. Second one is the IUPAC name. IUPAC name. Similarly, if you come across we have two carbons here, so it is ethyl fluoride. Is a common name. If it is IUPAC name, fluoroethane. Again, first one is common name, second one is IUPAC name. The simple compounds. Let us go in detail about the other compounds also in the case of the nomenclature. I'm taking three carbons. It is having 1, 2, 3 carbons. So here it is having propyl group, so where all the carbons are in the long chain, so this is N-propyl bromide. N-propyl bromide, and this is a common name. And its IUPAC name is 1-bromopropane. The IUPAC name, or else you shift this particular bromine to the middle carbon atom, will have so here this is actually isopropyl bromide. Isopropyl bromide. Of course, this is the common name. What is the IUPAC name? This is 2-bromopropane. 2-bromopropane. So all these comes under again the monohalogen derivatives. Monohalogen derivatives. We'll solve some examples for the polyhalogen derivatives. Polyhalogen derivatives. For example, you take CH2Cl2. For this, the common name we can call it as the methylene chloride. Methylene chloride. Methylene chloride. If it is IUPAC name, dichloromethane. dichloromethane. So first one is again common name, IUPAC name. Similarly, if you come across CH3CHBr2, as I told you here already, both the halogens are present on the same carbon atom, which are generally called as gem dihalides or geminal compounds. If it is the common name, we can also call this compound as here both the bromines are present on the same carbon atom, so which is gem dihalide. So the common name for this is ethylidene bromide. IUPAC name is 1,1 dibromoethane. But coming to this case, both the halogens are present at the adjacent carbons, which is ethylene bromide. The IUPAC name for this is 1,2 dibromoethane.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.